Hello everybody, this is Leonor with LDM Creations. Today I'm going to be doing a card using the Forever Young, and I'm going to be doing the mannequin on page 3, which is this little gal in here. And I'm going to be using the mirror on page 48, and the mannequin was on page 26. And what I did, I went ahead and pre-cut my stuff, and I did everything at 4.5 inches. So the first thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to assemble my card, and this is basically a regular 8.5 by 11 folded in half cardstock. And then I have the Martha Stewart ribbon, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and place it up in here for a little decoration. So let's go ahead and do this. Let's try to put the happy birthday so we can show here. And this trick I owe it to Robin from my pink stamper. She showed how to do it, except that she does it a lot more faster. Let's see here. So let's look. Make sure that it's straight. Let's see. So there we go. Oops. So here we go. Here's my card. And then what I'm going to do next is I'm going to go ahead and assemble the mannequin. And like I said, I went ahead and cut her. And I use the regular black stock, and then what I did is I use a little copper, I don't know if you can see it really well here in the light, a paper from Paper Source, and that's like a company here in my area. They have really pretty paper in there. So I'm going to go ahead and start assembling the girl. Like I said, I cut her at 4.5. And then the other thing that I did is I used the flip option on my Cricut, because I wanted her to face the other way. So that's why you see it flip. It doesn't look like the one in the cartridge there. So let's glue her here. Okay, so then I went ahead and just glued the dress on her. The next thing we're going to do is do her purse, and this is a very tiny little part. I'm going to go ahead and just use my tweezer here to glue it. Let's see, so that's going to be this way, and I think you can see that. And I just used that little pattern in there to put it, and then I cut also a tiny little flower to put it on her dress, and I don't know if you can see it, but I'm gonna go ahead and do the same because it's such a tiny little part. So let me go ahead and put it in here. Okay, so there we go. And then she's ready to go here. Okay, and the next thing that I did is I went ahead and cut my mirror. And then what I did for my mirror, I did it in two portions. The first one, I'm going to show you the shadow. This is on my cutout. This I cut it at 4.5. And then here's my mirror base. And then what I did is I used aluminum foil, and I cut the oval on it. And then I just basically glue my aluminum to some cardstock. And you can see basically what I did in here. So I just glued the aluminum onto these and made the cutout. So the next thing I'm gonna do is go ahead and glue my mirror. Okay, so then I have my little embellishment on my mirror, and it's just a little tiny flower that I bought in. I bought them in bulk in downtown, and your fashion district or your fabric district in your local town may be a really good source for these little things. And what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna go ahead and get the mirror and put the little flower up here and make it look pretty and feminine. Okay, so then the next thing that I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go ahead and adhere the little girl into the card, and we're going to kind of lay it together here in 1 minute. Okay, so now we're gonna put the card together, and what I did is I used some dimensionals. I just went ahead and glued them, and one of the tips is, you know, for the skinny parts of the card, what you can do is use the edges of it and cut them, you know, because that's a pretty good way of doing it. So I'm just gonna go ahead and probably place her here at the top of the card here. Okay, and I'm gonna do the same with my mirror here. And I use the bigger ones on this one because obviously it's bigger. Okay, let's put a line here. I think we're gonna do that. There you go. Okay, and next thing that I was gonna do is to finish it is I was gonna put my sentiment, and I'm gonna use the happy birthday stamp that I got from Walmart's card set. So we're gonna go ahead and do that. I'm gonna use our pink here. See here. And I'm gonna post it up here, and then I'm gonna make you know why. So I'm gonna put here happy birthday. Okay. Okay. It's my little crooked, but oh well, it's handmade, right? Okay, so then I got these also flowers in downtown, and what I was gonna do is I'm gonna place them down here. Okay, so I'm gonna do that. So here we go. Okay, so here's my happy birthday card. Let's go ahead and zoom it out a little bit. Let's see, maybe you can see a little better here. Here we go. So that's the birthday card, and hopefully they will like it. Here's the overview, and here's the little flowers and the little details, so you can see it. Okay, well, thank you for watching, and we'll see you next time.